Then equals to gamma bracket p. Okay, like this. Oh, perfectly same form. But wait, something which usually we use numbers, right? In the past few lessons, we always use numbers to represent. But this time, let's generalize it. So means that now it will be the general form. Means that we don't give any numbers, okay? We just give you the numbers as m, n, blah, blah, blah. Okay? And then here. Oh, wait. Wait. And then here the denominator become n times a to the power of 1 over n, like this. And then here. Now, of course, we must have the range. So where the range? Let's see. Okay, over n, as here I put u to the power of 1 over n, then here got the n power, wait, then what about the a? I'm going to take it out, so it become 1 over a to the power of m over n. Okay, then after that, e to the power of negative u. Oh, great! Here, 0 to infinity. Yes, that's what we want. E to the power of negative u. Oh, that means the next step already can change it to gamma. And then now, for du. Still got the u to the power of 1 minus, 1 over n minus 1 du, and I'm going to take this out, which over here could combine, which here a to the power of m over n could become a to the power of 1 plus m or m plus 1 both can over n. Okay, and then here, for this part of course stays the same. Let's see, what should we gamma? Oh, should we gamma? Oh wait, here I need to plus 1, right? Great thing that I didn't common denominator the power at first. Why didn't common denominator? Some of you sometimes will be like, oh wait, but I thought common denominator would be easier. Okay, so here, if you did not common denominator, you thought that here got a minus 1, and then the minus 1, at first we need to plus 1, so cancel. So that means just these two add together, m plus 1 over n. Oh, that's the answer. We no need to continue south since we don't even know why m or n. So let me just say one more thing. Thus, indefinite integral is of course special case, because there's sometimes definite integral you could solve more harder question, but definite integral is another special case. This kind is a special case because that it must be 0 to infinity, 1 to 2 cannot, 3 to 4 also cannot, must be 0 to infinity, because that as over here it's the gamma function. So let's just write down what it will be like. So here, which we will have the table, this, but we'll need to sub in because there's different scenarios. Different scenarios means that could have different answers. This one is just general. Maybe the question could be about this number, about that number. So let's try some of them, which, let's try these, okay? Over here. So we'll need to calculate for it. Let's start. And then here, this part will become 1 over a squared, right? Yes, it is. Then what if it's this? So it will become, let's sum it in. Okay, it will become 2 over a cube. And then this sum in becomes 6 over a to the power of 4. Then after that, for the 4, then become 24. Over a to the power of 5. Then after that, which becomes 120 over a to the power of 6. Okay. And then now, this part. Let's see. So, what if you have a 2? It becomes 1 over 2a. For this first part. For the second part, let's calculate. So, numerator, sub in the square root pi over 4 a to the power of 3 over 2. Okay, then after that, here, let's see. This which will become and then 1 over 2a to the power of 2, which is a square. And then now, 1 to the power of 4. Let's see. This part will become 3 square root pi over 8, a to the power of 5 over 2. And then what is this? Let's check. Can we or can't we? So we can put over here 1 over 2. Wait. It's a... Okay, so what I mean by 2, because that here denominator also have a 2, so simplify. I had to simplify at first. So, a to the power a is cubed. And then now, for this part, 3. So for this, 2 over 3. We cannot solve it, but we're going to first write the formula for it. Okay? We hadn't learned it up till now, this lesson. So here, let's see. If it's the general, 1 over 3, a to the power of 2 over 3, gamma, 2 over 3. Let's see, what about here? Can we? Oh, we can now. It's just that, this part, let's see. Will become okay. Three A. Okay, 1 over 3 A. And then next here, 4 over 3 cannot. So we just write the general form. 1 over 3, a to the power of 4 over 3, gamma, 4 over 3. So let's see, what about this? Also cannot. Which, write the general form, 3a to the power of 5 over 3, gamma, 5 over 3. So these three are these three that cannot, only now. And then now, what if it's over here? Oh, we can now. So what will it be? Let's see. So numerator still a one. Denominator, check. Three, a to the power, nope, a squared. That's for short. And then here, let's see, 4, 1 over 4, cannot, we haven't learned. So let's just write the general form. So 4a to the power of, wait a second, do you know that we actually can, since it's a half? Did you notice it? It's a half. So here, let's solve it. So half, numerator square root pi. And then denominator, let's see, 4a to the power of, half. Okay, that's not, I'm just trying to trick you, actually you can, not cannot. And then one is here, 3 over 4. Cannot, we haven't learned it yet. So general form, 1 over 4 times a to the power of 3 over 4 times gamma, 3 over 4. And then what about here? Let's see. Okay, now can again. So we got 4. Numerator 1, denominator 4a. And then, what about this? Cannot, so since we haven't learned it yet, so just write the general form. 1 over 4a to the power of 5 over 4 gamma bracket 5 over 4. Then what about this? Can we or can't we? I think that we can. As here 6 becomes 3 over 2. Oh, we learned it before. So we can. Square root pi. 2 then 8. A to the power of, so 3 over 2. Okay. Now what about here? This part, let's see. Oh, we haven't learned it yet. So 1 over 5 a to the power of 2 over 5 gamma 2 over 5. Okay, then for this, well, what if, wait, 3 over 5, we also haven't learned, so also cannot. So 1 over 5, a to the power of 3 over 5, gamma, 3 over 5. Oh, this one also cannot. So more bigger than more. The more cannot mean that until now, okay. It's until now, okay. So here, let's sub in since cannot. A to the power of 4 over 5 gamma 4 over 5. Okay, now here can. So, calculate it. A. So here's A and then gamma 6 over 5. So, okay, we can feel so much. Wow. This indefinite integral is special case because that indefinite integral only can solve cases like this. We can use indefinite integral to solve it. We also can use indefinite integral to solve this. And also, we also can use it to solve, for example, these two are combined to become this, okay? We still can solve. These two combined, we also can solve. It's just that. Using indefinite integral. Continue. If you like our video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.